Hello there, Miss Moore.
Hello.
Hi, my name is Dr. Mahmood. We met earlier today. I'm just going to have a word with my medical student to let me know what's going on with your father, and then I'll come back and have a chat with you. Is that alright? So this is Mr. Moore. He's 92 years old. He's a patient who's end of life. He's got a background of metastatic prostate cancer. He came in admitted with a UTI. We're treating that with antibiotics. He's in a very fragile state, so at the moment we're looking at keeping him as comfortable as possible in hospital, and the palliative care team are involved. So that's where we're at the moment. We'll have a discussion with his daughter now about what they'd like to do.
Stephen!
Miss Moore?
Stephen!
So we've had...
To go home! Stephen said that we are going home! Well, I'm here!
That's
I'm
okay.
Ready.
No problem.
We're supposed to be
leaving.
Can I have
some right help?
Now. He is late.
I know. It's okay.
Who are you?
Can we just get Smith back to her bed, please?
Right,
it's
of course.
Sorry. Who are you?
Can I please have the cannula for bed 16, please? And he's been waiting for the antibiotics.
Look, we need some privacy. Mr. Moore isn't doing too well. We'll get the cannula sorted in a second.
Okay.
Contact one of the juniors.
Yeah? Okay.
My medical student's busy at the moment taking notes.
Okay, all right.
All
Thank you.
Thanks. I'm sorry about that.
It's okay.
So where we're at, we discussed with you earlier about you wanting to take your father home to pass away. We discussed with your brother and sister yesterday, and we were kind of thinking that we should keep him in here. The reason being that travelling in the ambulance, I know it's only half an hour away to home, but travelling in the ambulance, there is a risk that he could die on the way. And from what they were saying yesterday, you wouldn't want that as a family. I don't know how you feel, but there is a risk of that, and I have to let you know that's what we want to do.
He has to stay here.
Yeah.
I want him to be comfortable. That's
cool. That's exactly what you want. If that's the case, I would suggest that, it's up to you, but I would suggest that we keep him here, keep him as comfortable as we can. We arrange a private room, so let's get a side room sorted. We'll get the palliative care team to come down again and just update you what's going on. But we'll make things as comfortable for him and for you as a family as we can. We'll get a car parking permit sorted out as well, so you don't need to worry about that. And we'll also get make sure we've got the red form in place. So the palliative care team discussed that with you yesterday.
Yes, and they came.
And they came earlier. Great, they're very good. So that's good to hear that they came earlier. We'll make sure we've got the DNR in place, and we'll stop some of the medications, I think, because some of them are unnecessary. There's no need to give them. They'll just likely cause side effects. He's finished his course of antibiotics, which is fine. Unfortunately, he's in this fragile state now where I think we need to keep him as comfortable as we can and keep him here in hospital in order to do that.
No,
if you're in agreement, then we'll do that. Okay, so arrange the side room ASAP. Speak to the nursing staff about that if we need to. And then we'll come back, my junior will come back and update you after we've got the side room sorted. And then we'll see. If there's anything else that you need, please do just let us know. And if there's anything else your family needs, or you feel your father would need, if you need any spiritual support, we can put you into contact with the chaplain service as well.
Thank you.
Is that alright? That's not a problem at all. Alright, and if you need anything at all, just let one of my colleagues, my medical student know, or one of the doctors or nurses that are on the ward.
Okay.
Okay?
Thank you.
Alright, take care
so
of yourself.
Much.
So let's get that side room sorted. Let's look at the medications. Let's stop the antihypertensives and the statins. And let's make sure the anticipatory medication is all written up. Check with the palliative care team that that's all correct. And just get an update from them on anything else they might have discussed when they came this morning. And that's it. But let's get the side room done, sorted as soon as we can. Antibiotics are finished, and that's fine. All right, and then have a check on that Miss Smith as well, because she looked very confused. Let's just make sure she's all right. Okay.